Hello, good evening everyone. I am Brother Aaron Spear. I'd like to welcome everybody to our online service tonight for Buckley Road Baptist Church. Thanks for Pastor Trav for asking me to, I was gonna preach at church tonight, but seeing as it's all online right now, he just told me to pre-record a message. So I'm recording this from my basement. It's the quietest place in my house. If you hear my dog barking or something like that, I'm sorry, I can't control her while I'm down here. But again, just thank you for Pastor Trav for asking me to do this. Just a couple quick announcements. Coming up Saturday is the meat feast, and we will be leaving our church at 3:15 to go to that. So anybody who signed up for that this Saturday, 3:15, we'll be leaving to go to the meat feast, and Brother Jim Walter is going to be there preaching, and we're going to have some good food. So it's going to be exciting. Can't wait for that. And so, without further ado, we'll just start right off with what I got for you guys today. So if you got your Bibles, we're going to be in Matthew chapter number 22. And I actually did this lesson at our teen convention. I was the morning speaker for our teen convention. So this is one of the lessons I taught to the teens. And I had an object lesson. I don't have the object anymore. What I used was these little tennis balls, or even little golf balls. I don't remember what. It was just some sort of ball. And on one ball I wrote God, and on the other balls it said work or school or games or friends or just any activities or stuff that you could do. And so I started off was, God was just kind of representing the relationship with God, and I was juggling just one ball, and it was real easy to juggle only one ball. It's not hard to play kind of catch with one ball by yourself. It's pretty easy. I can focus on that one ball, and nothing gets in the way, and it's easy to catch and throw back and forth. So I had another ball, and work or school, whatever, and I was juggling them, and pretty easy to do too, still not too hard. Well, I added a third one and a fourth one, and I tried to juggle. I'm not really good at juggling, so it didn't last very long. It's very hard to pay attention to three or four different balls flying in the air trying to juggle, right? And so I ended up dropping all of them. And the whole point of that was to show, the first one is just me juggling, it's me and God. Our relationship with God was good. I was focusing on Him and only Him, and it was great. I didn't drop it, I didn't get distracted or anything, but when I started adding more and more stuff, you could see I wasn't able to focus on God as much, I had to focus on other stuff as well. And it all just fell apart, and I dropped all the balls, and it just shows how distracted we can get, how we can get away from God, how we can get away from loving Him and serving Him when we start letting all these other distractions get in on our lives. And so it's kind of the point of the message I got. What do you love? What are you putting first in your life? Are you putting God first? Are you putting things of this world first? Are you putting your happiness before God, or material things, or just any other activity we can do? Are you putting those before God? If so, let's turn over in our Bibles to Matthew chapter number 22. Matthew 22. And we're gonna be starting off in verse 37, and this is most people are gonna know this when I start reading it. And in verse 37, it says, "Jesus said unto him, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment." So here we're seeing Jesus is telling us that we need to love God. We need to put Him first. We need to love Him with all of our heart, all of our soul, and all of our mind. And I just wanted to go through those three things and kind of talk about those and what exactly do they mean. So the very first thing that we've seen there is that we need to love God with all of our heart. We need to love Him with all of our heart. And so what does that mean when we love Him with all of our heart? So let's turn our Bibles over to Matthew chapter number 6. And in Matthew 6, starting off in verse 19, it says, "Lay not for yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. So we see here, Jesus is talking. He's telling them, lay not up for yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, where thieves break through and steal. You know, it's fun to have stuff here on earth. There's a lot of fun things we can do. It's cool to have games. It's cool to have, you know, toys or just fun stuff that we like to do. But it says here that moth and rust doth corrupt. You know, all that stuff is going to break down. It's not going to last. It's not going to last forever. You know, you see it with cars and with, you know, four-wheelers, snowmobiles, and all this cool stuff that we get to drive around. But it goes through one winter here in New York, and they get all rusty and nasty and destroyed. And they ain't going to last forever. And also says where thieves break through and steal. You know, if people know you have stuff of value and you're going around bragging about it and telling people all this cool stuff you have, you know, there's going to be people who find out and who are going to want to steal it and take it. You know, nothing here on earth is going to last forever. It might be fun for just a little while, but it's not going to be fun forever. We won't be satisfied anymore by those things, and we'll just need to keep getting more and more stuff to satisfy or try to satisfy that desire for stuff, but we'll see that it doesn't. Look what verse 20 says. It says, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. You know, when we're serving God and when we're leading others to Christ and when we're just living right for Him and treating others right and we're just serving Him with our lives, you know, we're laying up treasures in heaven that we're going to be able to have forever, and we'll eventually lay them at the feet of Jesus. We'll give them to Him, but we need to make sure we're laying up those treasures in heaven. Make sure that we're serving God. Make sure that we're doing right and that we're telling people about Him. You know, that's what's going to last forever. Nobody can take away any of the things that we have done for God. And look what verse 21 says. It says, for where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. So take a look at yourself. You know, where is your treasure? Do you treasure just things here on earth? Are you trying to always please yourself with material things? Are you trying to always have the very best, next best thing, or trying to always have the coolest stuff to try and make you feel good or look cool or whatever it may be? Is that all you treasure? Or are you treasuring God? Are you treasuring the things of God? Do you read His word? Are you serving Him? Are you telling people about Him? Look at yourself and see where your heart is. It says, for where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. You can see where you're at by looking at your treasure. Is your treasure God? Is it in serving God? You know, if you took away all the worldly things that you had, would you still want to serve God? Would you still love Him? Or would you think your life is over? Would you think that you have nothing left anymore and that you can't ever go on with your life? So we need to take a look at where our treasure is. You know, maybe you're somebody who is on the opposite end, kind of maybe struggles taking care of yourself, struggles making ends meet. Maybe you don't have that much stuff. Maybe it's hard. You live maybe a hard life and you're kind of worried a lot about taking care of yourself. And that might be, that's a big issue. And you know, you need to be taken care of. We need to make sure we can have food and have a house and can feed our kids and can take care of ourselves. But you know, Jesus in this same chapter tells us not to worry about that stuff. And so we'll see if you look at verse number 31, Matthew 6, verse 31, it says, therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that ye have need of all these things. Verse 33. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. So, we see here, I'm not going to go through the whole chapter in Matthew 6, but, you know, Jesus is talking about, you know, he says, therefore, in verse 25, therefore I say unto you, take no thought of your life, what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink, nor yet for your body, what ye shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body more than raiment? Behold the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are you not much better than they? Which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto his stature? That'd be pretty cool if we could add a cubit unto our stature. If I could just think about it and be taller, that'd be amazing. You know, I love playing basketball. I played in high school. Imagine if I could have thought of being taller and made myself taller. Who knows where I'd be? Maybe in the NBA. I'd be 7'5". I'd be amazing at basketball. That'd be awesome if I could do that. But we can't. So we see here, you know, he's saying, don't take thought for your life, what you're going to eat, what you're going to drink, or what you're going to put on your body. You know, we can't be worrying about that stuff. It says in verse 33, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. So just serve God. Put him first. Seek the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Seek to do right. Seek to obey God. Obey his word. Read his Bible. Obey his word. Serve him. Tell people about what Jesus did for you. And it says, all these things shall be added unto you. He'll take care of you, whatever you need. You know, you might not be rich. You might not have all the coolest or most fancy stuff. But you know that you will be taken care of. He loves you. And God loves you and wants to bless you. And he will take care of you if you're doing right. And you are serving him. So I believe that's what it's talking about when it's loving God with all of your heart. You know, don't get so caught up in things of this world and in wanting stuff or trying to have all this cool stuff, but just serve God. He'll take care of you. You don't have to worry about all those worldly things and how we're gonna live and stuff. If you just serve God, he'll take care of you and provide for you. All right, and the second thing that we've seen there in Matthew chapter 22, it says that we're to love him with all of our soul, with all of our soul. And, you know, so I believe it's talking about, you know, do you know God? Do you know him as your Lord and Savior? Have you put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ? Let's turn over real quick to Hebrews. In verse number 6, it says, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. So we see here, without faith, it's impossible to please him. You know, we're supposed to love all of our soul. How can you love God if you don't have a relationship with him, if you haven't put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ? You know, if you don't know somebody, it's pretty hard to love them. You don't know anything about them. You know, that's a hard thing to do. And you see here, without faith, it's impossible to please him. We can't please God before we're saved. You know, there's nothing that we can do. There's no good that we can do that can get us to heaven or that'll be pleasing to God. We all need to put our faith and trust first in Jesus Christ. And also, 1 John chapter 4, in verse number 9, it says, in this was manifested the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only Son begotten into the world that we might live through him. Herein is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. So we see here, you know, and for us to love God, you know, it's not that we loved God, but he loved us and sent his Son for us to die on the cross for our sins. He loved us so that we can love him. And also Romans 5:8 says, but God commendeth his love toward us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. So God, he loved us so much, he sent his only Son to die on the cross for our sins. And what do we need to do in order to love him, in order to please him, in order to serve him, is we need to put our faith and trust in Jesus Christ. You know, if you're not saved, if you're not 100% sure if you die, that when you die that you'll go to heaven, put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ. He came down to earth. He lived the perfect sinless life. He died on the cross, paid for your sins, took the sins on of the whole world, of everything that I've ever done, everything that you've ever done. He took those sins on, and he paid the penalty for that sin, which is death. And then he rose again 3 days later from the grave. And now he's in heaven. He's coming, and he'll be coming back soon to get us all. But you need to put your faith and trust in that. He loved you so much, he died for you. Pray, ask God to save you, repent of your sins, accept him into your heart. And then you can love God, and then you can start serving him. Now that's what I believe this little section of that verse meant, with loving God with all of your soul. We need to make sure that we know him, and we put our faith and trust in him, and then we're able to go and serve him and love him and start doing things for him after we put our faith and trust in him. You know, and the last thing that we've seen here in that section said, and love God with all your mind. And we need to love him with all of our mind. What does it mean to love him with all of our mind? I've actually been teaching the teens a lot, talking about the mind and how important it is. You know, growing up, I never really understood exactly how important it is for your mind to be right, to be thinking about the right things, and not to be filling it so much with things of this world. Or, you know, there's so much garbage and so much bad stuff that we can see on TV or on YouTube, on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and all this different social media and stuff. Now there's so much just garbage on there that we could be filling our mind with, and we really need to be paying attention to that and paying attention to what we're watching. You know, are you thinking about God daily? Do you meditate on his word? You know, do you read his word every day? Are you filling your mind with scripture? You know, Romans chapter 12, verse number 2. I'll just turn there so make sure I don't say it wrong. Romans chapter 12, verse 2. It says, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. You know, so Romans chapter 2 is telling us we're not to be conformed to this world. We're not to be like this world. You know, we talked a little bit about how does the world think. The world, they want to just please themselves. They want to do what feels good. They want to do what brings pleasure to them. The world wants everything to be perfect, and they claim they want it to be nice and friendly and all this, but it's all just to make themselves feel good. It's about making their lives as easy as could be and just this feel good kind of stuff. It's all about pleasing yourself. We're not to be like that. We're not supposed to be just thinking about ourselves all the time. We're supposed to be serving God, loving God. We're supposed to be a living sacrifice. Romans 12:1 says we need to surrender our own desires, surrender our own wants, and surrender the things that please us. And we can't be living like that. We need to be a living sacrifice and serve God. Whatever he has called us to do, whatever he has for us to do, we need to give up our own desires and give those to God and do what he wants us to do. Don't be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. You know, we need to think different in the world. We can't be thinking about the same things that they think about. We can't be involved in the same things that they're involved in or want to be a part of those things. We need to think different than them. How is our mind renewed? It's renewed first when we get saved, and then by reading God's word and by filling our mind with good godly stuff. You know, are you filling your mind with immoral music? You know, music is huge. One of the things that really helped me when I started getting involved in the church and when I really started to grow was when I changed the music that I listened to. I used to listen to like rock music and you know, a lot of pop music or whatever, and it just talks about, you know, rock music especially is very, you know, it's angry. It gets you in an angry mood. The lyrics are angry. You know, talk about anger and hate and, you know, some violence or whatever, and you know, it gets you in that mindset. You might not think it does, but music's very very powerful. When you're listening to rap music or pop music, you know, you might think that the beat just sounds cool or whatever, but when you listen to the lyrics, it's talking about just horrible stuff that nobody should be listening to. and it fills your mind, and you never forget it. You might think, oh, I'm just listening to it. I don't really, you know, it doesn't really mean anything. But when you listen to music enough times, you know, there's people who I know who say they can't sing, they don't like singing or whatever, but they can hear any song and they know it, and they can sing along to it. It might not mean anything by saying those words, or they might not think they do, but you remember that stuff, and it sticks in your mind. That's what you're filling your mind with when you're listening to that stuff. Or you're filling it with TV and Snapchats and TikToks. You know, I don't have those apps at all, but I know what they are. I'm only 27, so I still have an idea kind of about some of the apps and stuff that are out. And it gets very, it's addicting. You can sit there on your phone and scroll through Instagram or TikTok, and you're just scrolling, and you might be sitting around, you know, you think it's just a few minutes goes by, and you look up and it's been like half an hour, and you were just looking through. You don't even remember anything that you looked through, but half of it was probably just garbage filling your mind. And it's people doing, you know, dances or singing or just doing goofy stuff on the internet, but you know, it's just addicting, and you're not going to be it's just nothing good to it. You might not be looking at anything horrible, but you're just wasting time. You're not filling your mind with you know, anything good. You know, a lot of times when I'm working or whatever, I drive around a lot during work, so I have podcasts playing or YouTube playing just in the background. I'm always trying to make sure I'm listening to good godly music or watching, you know, maybe listening to somebody preach or something like something like that, something that I'll know that I'll remember that's helping me learn about God or learn just learn something, you know, useful. You know, are you thinking about God? You know, are you thinking about what He did for you on sending His Son Jesus to die on the cross for your sins? You know, that's what we need to be thinking about, is what He did for us. You know, recently, last year, I bought a new four-wheeler. When I got the four-wheeler, that's all I could think about was when I got it. I was watching YouTube videos on putting new stuff, I'm putting new parts on it to make it faster, make it look cooler. I was looking up videos of people racing it to see how fast it was and all this stuff. And man, it was like all I could think about for a while. You know, I had to be careful. Like, I could be sitting there just watching YouTube videos about a four-wheeler for all day, and that's you know, it wasn't good. Nothing bad with four-wheelers. I love the four-wheelers, but you know, I wasn't thinking about thinking about God. I probably wasn't doing all that I could because I was just distracted by this four-wheeler, even though it is really fun. But you know what we need to be filling our mind with is His Word. Let's turn over to 2 Timothy. Chapter 3, verses 16 and 17. It says, "All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works." So we need to make sure that we're reading God's word. It's only going to do good for us when we're reading His word and we're filling our mind with God's word. It's only going to do us good. You know, it gives us doctrines, profitable for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. It's going to show us, you know, the doctrines that we need to know so we know the right things about God. It'll teach us correction, what we're doing wrong. That'll show us what we need to do to get that right. And instruction in righteousness, so it teaches us how to live, how we're supposed to live and act. That's what it's for. And it says that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. You know, the Word of God is going to equip us to be able to go and serve God. You know, we're going to be able to do things the right way, and we're going to be able to have the Scripture to back up things that we tell people. And it's just going to get us prepared and grounded to go and tell people about Jesus. It's going to get us prepared to go and serve Him. So that's what we need to be filling our mind with, is God's Word. You know, that's how we're going to be able to serve Him, and that's how our mind is going to be right. That's how we're going to get rid of all that junk in our mind, is when we start reading God's Word and listening to good godly music and listening to preaching and just get rid of all the, you know, get rid of the worldly stuff that you fill your mind with and fill it in with good godly stuff. And, you know, so that's what I got going through those, that verse there in Matthew 22 with about loving God with all your heart. You know, don't treasure things on this earth. Don't treasure material things or any possessions that you have, but treasure God. Put Him first. Seek to serve Him and to just live right and obey His word, and He'll take care of those things. You don't have to worry about being taken care of, because He'll do that for you if you put Him first. Love Him with all your soul. You know, do you know Him? Have you put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ? If you haven't, I urge you to do that as soon as possible. He loves you. He sent His Son Jesus to die on the cross for your sins, and all you have to do is repent of your sins, pray, and ask Him to save you, and you can be saved. And then you'll be free to finally live a life that can be pleasing to God and serve Him with your life. So love Him with your soul. And lastly, love Him with all your mind. You know, don't get rid of, if you have things that you know you need to get rid of, maybe music or TV or whatever, there might be anything in your mind that could be holding you back from fully serving God. You know, I urge you to get rid of those things. Start reading the Bible more. Listen to good music, godly music. Get rid of maybe some TV shows or movies or anything else that could be holding you back from serving Him. And start filling your mind with God's words. It's only going to help you to grow. It's only going to help you to learn more about God and to serve Him better. And so that's what God laid on my heart for you guys. So I'll close this in a word of prayer. Dear Lord, just thank you so much for today, God, and the time we get to be here in your house, Lord, and here in my basement. And I just pray, God, that you would be with all of us, Lord, to take what we learned today from your word, God, and just apply it to our lives. God, help us, Lord, to just love you with all of our heart, soul, and mind, God. And I just pray that you'd be with any of us who are, there was quite a few people sick this week, Lord. Pray that we'd all be able to recover quickly, Lord, and that we'd all be able to get back into church and start feeling better soon, Lord. And be with Pastor Travis and Melissa and Zach Elizabeth as they're down in Oklahoma. Pray that you'd be with them and just get them home safely when the time comes for them to return home, Lord. And we just thank you so much, Lord. We love you, and we ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, thanks for tuning in. We'll see you all Sunday morning.